You're still keeping malice. Throw that thing out. Don't let the malice of old year spoil the new year for you. Because this year, nothing will spoil your blessing. And the blasphemy and the filthy communication out of your mouth. In verse 9, lie not one against another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds. It says, throw them out, don't allow them to stay. In Ephesians chapter 4, I'm reading from verse 22. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 22. That she put off concerning the former conversation, the old man, put him off. The old nature, put that off. The old characteristic, put that off. And the old habit, put that off, that she put off concerning the old, concerning the former conversation, the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust. And then it tells us from verse 27, neither give place to who? Tell me out loud. The devil. How do you stop giving place to the devil? Revelation calls the devil the old serpent. The old serpent. And once you allow old thoughts, old ideas, old behavior, old character, old malice, old anger, the old serpent likes and loves those old things. You're giving invitation to the old serpent, that is the devil. But when you repent of the old thing, you throw off the old thing, then that makes new, that makes everything new in your life. In verse 28, let him that stole steal no more. Stealing is of the past in Jesus' name. But rather let him labor. Why don't we steal? Have you noticed that the people who steal, they never prospered? Never prospered. They never prospered. It's what you earn that makes you to prosper. It's what you sow that you reap very well. You know, but the people that allow other people to have their money, bear their harvest there, and then they go to steal, they never prosper. The people who want to be winners, who want to be successful, who want to be conquerors, who want to be prosperous, they don't steal. You will not steal. Let him that stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, walking with his hands, the things which is good, that ye may have to give to them, to him that needeth. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth. Amen. Amen. I said amen. Amen. You know, nobody wants to, you know, get near you when your mouth is having bad odor. And filthy communication puts out bad odor. It makes just make the whole environment stink, and people turn away their faces, they turn away their mind, they turn away their lives from you, because they say that thing coming out of his mouth is smelling, is stinking. Stinking words, dirty words, bitter words, and words that will create fury and fire and bring unpleasant things. Let no evil, corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace to the hearers, and grieve not the Holy Spirit. You know what? Anger grieves the Holy Spirit. Wrath gives the Holy Spirit. And when you strive and fight against one another, that grieves the Holy Spirit. And if you want the Holy Spirit to be present in your life every time, your ministry every time, and in all around you every time, anger and all those things must get away. It says, grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby ye are sealed unto the day of redemption. Let all bitterness. How many kinds of bitterness? Everything, and all wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. And then in verse 32, and be kind one to another, tender hearted. Tell me the next thing. Forgiving one another, forgiving one another. Why does this say forgiving one another? I thought this is a new year, and nobody will offend me in the new year. You know what? You cannot guarantee everybody else changing in the new year. The only thing you can guarantee is you changing. You cannot guarantee your neighbors changing. You cannot guarantee all your friends changing. You cannot guarantee anybody changing. The only person you can guarantee that will change this year is who? It's you. And when you change, everything around you will change. You know, you cannot guarantee that everybody will smile when you meet them in the morning. The only thing you can guarantee is that you will smile. And when you smile, it will produce smile from them. You cannot guarantee that everybody will be gentle. But you can guarantee that you will be gentle. And when you change, everything else will change. And when people do something that you say, why do they do that? You say, that's the wrong question. New question. This is a new year. I cannot change everybody. How should I respond to what they're doing? I should love them and forgive them, forgiving one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, as forgiving you. When God forgives, he doesn't keep on telling you, remember what you did, 19 such and such, and 2009. Remember what you did. When God forgives, he forgets. And that's what the Lord wants you to do this year. He wants you to forgive. You will forgive in Jesus' name. That means then, if we're getting into the new year, we're going to have new blessings in this new year. We must forget some things and forsake some things. Number one, forsake the old prophet. Forsake the old prophet. Number two, forsake the old priest. The old priest. Number three, forsake the old passion. The old passion. Number four, forsake the old parables. Number five, forsake the old practices. And number six, forsake the old places. And then number seven, you forsake the old principalities and powers. Number one, forsake the old prophet. We're looking at First Kings chapter 13. First Kings chapter 13, and I'm reading here from verse 11. First Kings chapter 13. We're looking at verse 11. Now there dwelt an old prophet in Bethel. And his sons came and told him all the works that the man of God had done that day in Bethel, and the words which he had spoken unto the king, them he told also unto their father. And eventually, you know what the old prophet did? He went after that man of God and then found him resting under a tree and said, are you the man of God that came to our city? He said, yes, I am. Why don't you come home with me? And then the man said, I cannot, because the word of the Lord has told me this definitely. I cannot do that. I said, but I'm a prophet like you are. And the angel of God spoke to me and said, I must bring you back home so you can eat with me. And he went back. What happened to him later? A lion killed him, slew him, destroyed his life. He died prematurely. That's what the Lord is saying. This is a new year. Forsake the old prophet. Number two, forsake the old priest. The old priest. We're looking here now at 1 Samuel. We're looking at 1 Samuel chapter 2. 1 Samuel chapter 2. I'm reading from verse 22. 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 22. Now Eli was very old, and had all that his sons did unto Israel, and how they lay with the women that assembled at the door of the tabernacle of the congregation. Verse 29, wherefore keep ye at my sacrifice and at my offering, which I have commanded in mine habitation, and honorest thy son above me, to make yourselves fat with the chiefest of all the offerings of Israel.
I'm hoping that you have been blessed with this powerful message. Our address is at the bottom of the screen. I believe you will join us one of this Sunday to worship together. Thank you. God bless you. Let us pray. Our mighty Father, we glorify your name and thank you, Lord, because of this powerful message. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, you will touch those people who are in need of salvation, those people who are in need of prosperity, those people who are in need of healing. And by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, they will give testimony because of this message. In Jesus' name we pray.
Say it one more time, say, oh, 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 Lord.